United network of global corporations.
What are you here for?
Whose interest is global corporate takeover of all means of production.
What's happening?
That's how it should be.
We want to know if you're here with us protesting.
You see, Jordan, pardon me?
We want to know if you're here with us protesting.
Just protesting
Fiorina. No. CEO Fiorina is the best thing that the public court has going in for California.
So when you say that's the way it should be, all taken over, what does that mean?
What I want to do is just
want to
picture
it. Let's go back in time. The King of England and the British Parliament, that was the first republic court. They incorporated with the East India Company.
Right. Trade.
And Washington, Revere, Samuel Adams got in the way. They won the first battle. But with Citizens United, we're winning the war.
So what war? I'm trying to figure that out.
Global corporations controlling the world. Each corporation is sort of like a lord of whatever it sells. The East India Company would have been the Lord of Tea. Okay. The East India Company would have been the Lord of Tea. But George Washington stopped that. See, we could have taken over centuries ago.
So is Microsoft the Lord of Software?
There you go.
Well, where does that put Apple?
Well, they're it's like the Lords of all time. They battled it out.
What about Intel? What about Intel? Sun Microsystems.
Well, they have their own little realms within the larger global world.
Well, isn't that just good competition?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So
and if, you know, if, what do we call it? Social Darwinism. If you believe in social Darwinism, that's the competition we're talking about. First, there's people who try to fix the market, you know, they call them the rich and well connected. That's not true. It's really nature everywhere.
Can I get your name?
Sure. My name's on the back of my flyer.
You know, I don't want anything more to carry right now.
It's too bad. This took 6 weeks to edit. Five lawyers.
You're Albert Kilrankley?
I don't write. I just shoot pictures.
Albert what? So you're Albert, right?
Yes.
Albert? Okay. Spell your last name?
K-I-L-L.
Albert Kilrankley.
A-C-K-E-Y.
And are you...
Yes,
I'm making a...
Supporting Fiorina?
Republic Corp is supporting Fiorina.
Okay.
Marvelous.
There'll be a larger delegation here, about 25, 30 people. We're bringing a couple of $1 million checks from global corporations.
Marvelous.
To support their
outstanding
candidacy.
Outstanding.
And they're our official spokesperson.
So you don't like boxing?
Republic Corp is opposed to boxing. She would oppose the global corporate takeover. That doesn't help. Boxer does not help corporate.
Global corporate
takeover. Boxer is like George Washington.
So you think there can be a global corporate takeover?
Pardon me?
You think there can be a global corporate takeover?
It's in process. It goes back. Remember, a lot of Republicans today, people don't read. But if they read, they would know about a guy named President Eisenhower. Great, a true Republican.
I voted for him.
You should have. He was an American hero.
Yeah.
I sincerely mean that.
General Eisenhower.
But he turncoat. He left after 50 years in public service. He said, beware the military-industrial complex. What is he doing? That was the first stronghold of Republic Corp in America. And he's saying, beware. And now look what we have. At least... Reagan Revolution got rid of that Eisenhower stuff.
So this looks for a bit like a front that you're not really supporting Carly Fiorina.
Right.
Well, pursuant to the
my
Supreme Court...
My paper is my personal opinion. It's not moveon.org.
Well, but it certainly doesn't look like you're supporting... It looks like you're kind of making a mockery of it.
Confidential memorandum. You're really not supposed to be reading it. Like all this, it's speech. Confidential immunity.
Well, sure, but you're talking about her her compensation, right?
That's what it is.
Do you understand that
she
a
knows it?
Do you understand who sets her compensation?
What?
Board of directors.
Who sets,
yeah, board of directors.
The people.
So who is made up of the board of directors of HP that set Carly's compensation? Who is the board of directors of HP that allocated and actually agreed to the contract and signed the contract for Carly at HP at HP's board of directors? Who were they? Were they conservative? Were they Democrat?
Can I get you on video?
I don't care. All I know is that she is a great candidate because she believes in trickle-down economics. You take the money you save from not being taxed and you trickle it down into foreign nations. The biggest buildings are built in foreign nations now. The fastest electric trains are built in foreign nations. By workers who, well, they have universal health care. I don't know how they got that through.
But it's a nice sham you're running. It's a nice sham.
Sam?
Sure.
Well, they'll be here with the checks in a little while.
Oh, sure. I'm sure they will be.
Yeah, soon I hope we have these.
Well, maybe you guys should educate yourself a little bit more about how those corporations work.
Have you ever
been an executive at a major corporation?
One of the guys that helped me edit my paper, I'm public interest lawyer, but one of the guys that helped me edit it is a corporate lawyer. Been so for 20 years.
I've had plenty of corporate lawyers work for me that don't know squat about the business. They know about an intellectual property agreement, they know how to draft an agreement, but they don't know anything about running the business. And they don't know how it works.
George Washington was like that either. He didn't know a damn thing about business. Neither did Samuel Adams. What a jerk. Stop corporate takeover of America back then. You know how far we could have come since then?
Far we could have come with what? More
global
government?
Global takeover. It would have happened 200 years ago.
Nice sham.
Real,
nice job. It ain't real. It ain't real. It's called delusion.